Sungyun looking for this level 3 gank. They want to get Shy rolling early. Marin's going to flag and drag, but gets interrupted. Has to use the flash there as well as Shy. Another Counter-Strike comes in. Spirit turns up late, and Sungyun's going to pick up. Sorry.
Decent damage, and you mentioned the Thunderlords. That's possibly going to send for a home.
Counter-Strike's there, Spirit waits for it. There's the Flash Body Slam, all too easy in the Flash.
Back in there, should actually be in parity as Spirit.
Lava.
Yeah, just continuing the aggression here. Kuro going so ham as this melee Corki. And another big Body Slam Flash forced out of Kuro as Lava knows that he's dead. The red buff is still ticking down, and look at the fat man. This is so aggressive as he bonks him in the back of the head with a barrel.
Side nice. Priority that no one has really been able to put down the vision to get that is Lava again.
Yeah, doesn't have Flash available as well. He's going to be able to take a magical journey, but there's a Cataclysm, and Marin wants more key. Now forced to run away, uses the Exhaust, which is a big cooldown already, but Marin still wants this fight. Good Cosmic Binding stops him, but oh, Spirit, that was stunning. The knockback's there in key. He can't juke that one as Marin grabs himself his second kill.
He actually turns on the aggression with the Gatling gun, but Freaker Freaks won't be deterred from this.
I mean, this is a poor read, though. Rox could have taken a free Drake and Shy got out. We'll just use Vash to interrupt.
Yeah, Marin actually now looking to try and make his way out, but that's going to be the kill. They can't even get the follow-up. The Songwan's going to eat up that Fury. Pick up that kill is now Kramer. Towards the bottom side, they're looking for Tucson. Featherstorm's great, but it slows him down. Now Kramer has the ultimate. Just got enough mana for that one. Not going to find as much towards the bottom side, but nice work from the Tigers to try and get something back on the back end.
There's he's alone.
Yeah, he's also going to get stunned and most likely murdered. There's, okay, over... Yeah. So this is going to be the replay of what happened on the bottom side. Tempered Fate means that Tucson goes down low, but Flashes gets himself out. And the Key's like, we can do this.
I mean, the only reason for Key to go on a solo mission like this, even with both summoners up, is if that Exhaust is Ignite, but he doesn't have Ignite. He has Exhaust, so he just walks up, and what exactly was supposed to happen?
I guess Unbreakable was supposed to be down.
He went to walk up a lot more frequently. Speaking of walking up.
Oh yeah, he's just going to try and stop Key from getting into the Magical Journey as they follow it through. They're looking for it. One auto is all they need, but Key doesn't fall down. Winter's Bite gets it.
Damage on Marin,
and they're looking for first brick here as well. Lava turns up. There's the Flash. Gets over the top, and Kramer turns that one around. Looking good. Dissonance comes in, and now someone's here. They're looking to try and turn this. Still 3v3 as Kramer, being a bit of a hero, gets himself the heal, and Lava turns that one around, but it was very, very close from Kramer. Now Shy teleports in, doesn't get anyone as the Cataclysm now for Marin. And look at the AoE damage. The ult comes out from someone, and he gets out. Call Kuro down there as well. So remember, there's no turret. So Shy possibly in trouble. There's no package for Kuro, but he gets over with the Valkyrie. There's the Leap Strike. He's going to head onto a tunnel, but now it's on cooldown. And Shy with no flash will just die. Marin picks up that kill, and it's nice.
Songwan spotting people, but Sungyun's on the back foot. Till now.
There goes Sungyun, throws out the jump in. He's going to get a lot of damage in there. Featherstorm comes down, they get the root. So Tucson, he's very healthy at the beginning, but taking so much abuse. And now they're looking for the dive onto Kramer. Four members underneath the turret. And Lava throws the Nebula. Shy not going to get knocked up. Try and turn this one around as Marin just opts in and he's going for this 1v1, knows that he's got the whole rest of the team moving on down and package is going to be delivered. Kuro with a lot of damage, but there's another Leap Strike, but another Valkyrie's there to answer. And they do not want to give him anything. Oh, mid-leap. And Kuro
autos in. They're respecting the potential flanks in Marin.
And he's going to flag and drag his way out. Now the pincer move comes in from Rox. They're looking for that perfect shockwave that Lava can now line up. Finds it onto three, actually. Lots of damage, but good redemption. Gets a lot of the health back. Doesn't stop Sungyun from grabbing Tucson in this fight, though. He's going to fall down, and Lava's going to follow up with a kill on Demara. Now they're streaming through as Kuro and Spirit are so low. Tigers, they're down 3,000 gold, but you couldn't tell. Skuro's going to jump his way in. No Counter-Strike. And okay, Shy has to be a little bit careful here. Spirit looking for it. Kramer's going to be able to take down Tucson, and look, he's just going straight through the front door. Spirit wants to be able to get in there, and Spirit doesn't manage to pick up the Baron, and he's going to lose his life for it as well. Kramer, so much damage is Sungyun. Oh, the rip up! It's going to burn him down. Double kill now.
It could have gone either way. The secure was there eventually. Shy, definitely bold, trying to buy time, but they just realized that we have to burn it down. Baron damage, the large reason that the Bard goes down. You see the Baron fall low. There certainly could have been a steal. He had vision here, Spirit. But the only smite came through from Sungwan. Only claim comes through from the Rek'Sai, and they managed to clean up Kramer as well.
Oh yeah, just the red buff. Calculated there by Sungwan.
Rocks are in no position to fight over, so not going to be too worried about that. They'll just push through mid.
Going to be traded for this tower though. Good knock up onto Tucson, who takes a lot of damage. Glacial Fissure
Watch
comes
spirit.
In, a Freak of Freaks. Yeah, they're looking for the flanking play. Marin is going to be in there as Shy sets up the counter-strike, but good split from Spirit as he leap strikes his way in. Going to get knocked up as Shy may have gone too far forward. Good Winter's Bite. And that's going to be Tucson lining up the jacks and taking him down. Key is so incredibly low as there's the Cataclysm straight into the knock-up of Sungwan. Very healthy. Explosive cast comes in. Void Rush just means that Sungwan is going to be able to buy some time. But it's just enough movement speed. And Key throwing down that hot cocoa and help Sungwan
move faster. Lava Marin.
Yeah, jumps in right on top of him. Lots of damage. Not going to get stunned just yet as Marin just ignores Sungwan's damage. Good exhaust onto Marin to stop him from killing the AD carry, but now a Freak of Freaks, they're looking for Shy. The top lane is buying as much space as they can.
Shy wasn't able to take anyone down, and now a Freak turn onto Baron.
Yeah, Sungwan is going to be able to get himself in here. Half health now on this Baron buff as the Rocks Tigers looking to try and make something of this fight. Key gets himself over the back, and it is going to be Spirit that locks up the Baron. Sungwan is going to fall as well, and I feel like this is just a repeat of exactly what happened.
It must have been just doing some work, and let's have a look at this fight once again. Lava probably felt a little bit safe, and then
yeah. Watch Marin come in. Marin comes in, starts to chunk out Lava, and as the fight goes on, Marin just goes in. DPS is down the Orianna. Meanwhile, Shy jumps in and takes the base.
Well, Chains of Corruption are going to stop them from moving around too much. Good redemption, but they lose the turret. There's the Cataclysm right on top of Lava once again, and it's not going to find anyone. The Shockwave and Kuro is the only one touched. They get rid of the Orianna again. Shy is going to go down. No more solo laners, and Sungwan just can't get in there to get the damage done. A Freak of Freaks, it's like they've just taken the game into their hands and they're looking to try and complete it. It's Kuro teleporting back in. They're going to keep that minion alive. Sungwan getting dove on, but should be okay. Marin pretty healthy. And Kuro just does so much damage. Flash is going to be used, but now they're relegated to the fountain. And Sungwan can't even go toe-to-toe with Kuro. Nexus exposed. A Freak of Freaks turn around that pretty decent Baron play from the Rocks Tigers. They're going to claim game three.
It feels like the Afrika Freaks stole the lunch money of Rocks Tigers. They had so many different ways to win the game, but it echoed that game one from Ever8 where they didn't set up side push or